So this month we're going to be looking at a supersaturated solution of sodium acetate, and I've brought Phil along with me. Say hi, Phil.
Hi, Phil.
There we go. And all I'm going to get you to do is to drip some of this solution onto these Petri dishes. Now, if you could just sort of point out to the viewers what we've got on these Petri dishes that you can see.
Oh, there's some sort of solution on that one at the front there.
Yep.
And these two are both empty.
Completely empty?
That one has some stuff on.
Yeah, okay, and there's a little sort of thing one as well, yeah. Okay, but we've got these sort of two little sort of crystals on there. So all I'm going to do is ask you to drip some of this liquid onto the Petri dish, and I will do this in a way so that everyone can see what's happening.
Yes.
That's right. So what's going on?
The solution's crystallizing kind of round the thing that was in there already.
Okay, do you want to keep going?
You can
basically make a nice big stalagmite with that. In fact, I'm going to get going with one of the other ones because this is a great film.
Great.
Is it frozen in the end?
Yes.
When I say frozen, oh, and of course, that is one of the problems that we get if you dip in a pipette into your solution. Then it will start going through there. Luckily, I've got some spare stuff.
Right.
Now, what I'm going to do is actually, with this one, just sort of show that there's a number of different ways of doing this. You can pop over our little solid piece there. Okay, and we can sort of see it immediately crystallizing there. Now, this is sort of something that I would do normally down a little bit lower down the school as opposed to with somebody your age. And I would probably sort of ask them to sort of think about what's happening in terms of the particles. So this is something I would use as a model for freezing. And with that in mind, when something freezes, are you visualizing that as being a process where heat is going to be taken in, or there's no change in heat, or heat's going to be released?
Freezing heat is taken in.
Okay, so if heat's taken in, then that means that this has got colder, warmer, or the same?
It means that it's got colder.
Okay, so if you want to sort of just sort of feel the bottom of that and...
That's warm.
So. Now, a little bit lower down the school in year 11, when you were introduced to the idea of energy to do with bonds, you would have been sort of told that there was an energy change when you break a bond and when you make a bond. And of course here, we're forming bonds from going from a liquid to a solid. What kind of energy change is associated when you form bonds?
An exothermic change.
Energy is being released as you sort of form bonds between particles. And this is one thing that we try to show, because you might expect, of course, we think of ice as being cold, but when we form a solid, when we're sort of forming bonds between particles, then actually that is a process that releases energy. And that's why I would sort of show this. So thanks very much, Phil.
It's okay.
We just need to have a look at sort of how we'd set up this solution and get going with it. But I'll say bye, Phil. Okay.
Thank you. Bye.
So here's my original supersaturated solution of sodium acetate, or sodium ethanoate if you prefer. And I made this by getting 125 grams of the sodium acetate and then heating that gently over a Bunsen with 12.5 grams of water. Now, with that ratio, you can obviously multiply that up or down with whatever you've got, 10 times by mass of sodium acetate. You'll find that it's a little bit light on the water side. So as you begin to cool that down, if you've lost any water by evaporation whilst you've been heating, you might find that it crystallizes a little bit early. You can reduce that effect by heating with a watch glass over the top and just removing that to stir occasionally. And if you really struggle to stop it from crystallizing, a little bit of extra water, it will still work just fine. And the demo is very simple. Start off with a crystal of your sodium ethanoate down on the watch glass, and you can begin to build some stalagmites. Now, if you find that the end of your pipette begins to crystallize, that's a good opportunity to have some other ones nearby, because you don't want to then get any solid anywhere near your original stock solution. I find it's quite handy to actually split down my stock solution so that if something goes wrong, then I've always got something else to fall back on. And I find that I get asked for this quite a lot because students really enjoy watching these things form. And the key learning point here is, of course, that freezing, of course it's not freezing, it's crystallizing out of a supersaturated solution, but it's a good model for freezing. This freezing is actually an exothermic process. Heat is being released, whereas most students will go into this thinking that freezing, of course, when you freeze things, they get cold, don't they? And so, therefore, heat is going to be taken in. There you go. So, supersaturated sodium acetate. Go ahead, form some stalagmites. And, of course, make sure that you've got somebody nearby who can feel the bottom of the watch glass and confirm that, in fact, heat has been released in this process.